This is your typical social media account. It's on Reddit, a popular internet forum. This account is giving relationship advice to someone who posted about their personal issues. In another post, the account is talking about their graduation ceremony. They are also giving advice about how someone can move on from their ex. They are posting jokes, sharing a photo about their dog, oh, and a possum. And at first glance, you might think, well, this looks like a typical social media account, right? Well, no. This account is actually a bot. It's been using other people's comments and pretending to be human, and it's doing a great job. So how do I know it's a bot? There are several reasons. For example, this account reused a response from a post 5 years ago, word for word. 5 years ago, on Reddit, someone asked the question, what's something you're proud of but really get to talk about? And a user called KingNix responded with this. A few days back, a new post appeared on Reddit, on the subreddit called AskReddit, and it asked the same question. What's something you're proud of but really get to talk about? And guess what? Our bot account responded by stealing the same response that was posted 5 years ago, word for word. This is a classic example of bot behavior. Another telltale sign is that the account posted on a subreddit called What is my CQS? CQS stands for Contributor Quality Score on Reddit. On Reddit, every account is assigned a CQS based on various signals. This can include past user actions, network and location data, and the steps taken to secure an account, such as an email verification. These scores are then used to place users on Reddit under 5 tiers. Highest tier means that you're probably human, and the lowest tier means that you're a bot and you are probably spamming Reddit. So in this specific subreddit, users ask, what is my CQS? And the auto-moderator responds. So this account posted on the subreddit asking for its CQS, a clear sign that it's a bot. In fact, many accounts posting on the subreddit are probably bots, but that's what is fascinating. Yes, this account is a bot, but it doesn't look like a bot, and it doesn't act like a bot. All these accounts are incredibly difficult to distinguish from humans. And what's worse is that this problem is not confined to Reddit. It's on YouTube, it's on Twitter, it's on TikTok. Chances are we're all communicating with or seeing content created by bots far more than we realize. But who are these bots? What do they want from us? And since this is a software-related channel, how are they even being created? A cybersecurity company called Imperva released a bad bot report this year, and it revealed that nearly half of all internet traffic come from bots. Of that 49.6%, a staggering 32% are bad bots who want to do naughty things. Now, it's important to note that not all bot traffic is bad. There are, in fact, good bots that perform useful jobs for us. For example, some bots monitor website performance. But then you have bad bots. And bad bots are software applications that are designed to perform automated tasks with some sort of malicious intent. And the growing popularity of these bad bots is a concern. A few years ago, you may have come across a bot or two, and it was pretty obvious. It was almost always related to crypto, and they would post something like this. And if you've spent some time on the internet, you would recognize this and think, oh, well, this is a bot, and I should ignore it. But things have changed. Bots have gotten smarter, and the sheer number of them is downright scary. And I guess the question is, why is there an increase in bots? The simple answer, it's become incredibly easy to create bots that are good at pretending to be human. All it takes is stealing someone else's code and, of course, leveraging humanity's best friend. No, not this guy. This guy. So, how easy is it to create a bot that's really good at pretending to be human? Pretty easy. Here's how. So, I wanted to create a bot, a human-like bot. And to keep things simple, I decided to create this bot on Reddit. For those who don't know, Reddit is a forum where you log on, view trending posts by specific topics. You can upvote or like posts, and you can comment on them. just like any other social media platform. So my idea was to create a bot that would find some random post and comment something on topic and relevant. Now, if you're a developer or a software engineer, especially a good one, you can create this bot using some sort of script and you can create it from scratch. But let's be honest, you're not here for the code, you're here for the drama. And I didn't want to write an entire script from scratch, mainly because I wanted to create a bot as quickly as possible. So I went to GitHub and searched for Reddit spam bot, and I found this pretty quickly. This is a Python script that someone else has created, and it has everything I need. The developer who created it describes it as a comment generator bot. It analyzes trending subreddits and top posts, and then it uses ChatGPT, the artificial intelligence tool, to generate and post an engaging comment. This is perfect. So I cloned the repo and took the code. Next, I went to Reddit and created a fake user account to act as my bot. And then I told Reddit I wanted to create an app and access the API. Reddit gave me a secret key and some details, essentially giving me the ability to use a bot on their platform. That part was honestly surprising. Reddit was like, oh, you're developing a bot. Sure, here's all the information you need. There were no checks to verify my intentions for creating the bot. They didn't ask for my phone number. To create the account, I used some spam email address like the 10 Minute Mail platform. And as soon as I created the account, I immediately requested a secret key to access the API, and Reddit granted it without any suspicion. Typically, a website should have restrictions, like requiring you to be an active user for 30 days before granting you access to the API. But Reddit, they were totally fine with it, which could explain their major bot issue. Anyway, once I had the details, I just had to simply input them into the script. I also needed an OpenAI key because I wanted to use ChatGPT, as ChatGPT would be generating some responses for me. So I got that as well. And that's all I did. I inputted all the necessary details and I ran the script. Essentially, this is what it did. It looked at trending posts on Reddit and then picked a random post. The script then performed some research. It reads through the post titles, the comments, and the content. And based on the research, the script generates a comment. And this comment gets automatically posted on my account. The script also provides notes on how ChatGPT should generate an engaging comment. So for example, my script tells ChatGPT to generate a comment that uses humor with witty observations, jokes, and also that it should use at most one emoji. And this can be changed if I wanted it to. So using OpenAI's GPT model, the script generated this comment for this post. And using Reddit's API, it posted it. It showed up live on that post and on my profile. Now, this comment was in reference to some game which I don't play, nor do I understand, but it seemed like a relevant comment. And this entire setup took a few minutes. And the comment that it outputted sounded natural, it sounded human, and it was engaging. I was able to do this without much effort, and now that I have the script, I can create as many comments as I want. Obviously, this also depends on how much money I want to put in to access OpenAI's API and use ChatGPT. But here's the crazy part. I can now custom the bot's behavior to create a large amount of comments that may say and end up saying malicious things. For example, in the part of the script where I give notes on generating a comment, I could add something like, subtly include in a natural way that people should contact me to learn how to turn $1 into $100 using binary trading. And that's exactly what I did. I told the bot to include this message and I ran the script again. This time it commented on this post and the bot posted this. Imagine if the fox called in sick because it couldn't find its briefcase. Fox emoji. By the way, if you want to turn $1 into $100, hit me up for binary trading tips. So this is a bit lame, but it did follow my instructions. And with more customization and prompt engineering, I could make it sound a lot more natural. And this kind of bot can be created on any social media platform. You can build an entire network of bots in a fraction of the time and program them to say whatever you want. It's incredibly easy. It was easy for me to do. And with the advancements of AI, it's only going to get easier. So now that we know how these bots are created, I guess the next step is to answer why they are created. The most well-known reason why bots are created is due to influence and manipulation. Bots can shape public opinion and sway trends. When it comes to the media, that is probably the scenario that gets hyped the most: political disinformation bots. But honestly, it doesn't seem like these are the everyday bots we encounter on social media. The everyday bots that appear on social media are generally there for two reasons. One is to scam us and take our money, and two is to sell a product that's either illegal or frowned upon. So let's talk about it. When it comes to scams, some of the most common bots are the not safe for work bots. And I'm sure you've probably seen it. These bots flood social media with explicit images and content, often including links to shady websites. And the goal here is to lure users into clicking these links, which can be phishing scams where you unknowingly give personal details, or it could just install some sort of virus or malware. You see this quite often on Instagram, Facebook, and sometimes Reddit. Some bots even go a step further and pose as trusted accounts, offering some sort of support. TikTok is flooded with this. Nearly every video I post on TikTok is riddled with bots. These bots comment and claim that their account was hacked, but some specific person actually got their account back for them. And this is all a lie. These bots are looking for any potential victims who have their accounts hacked, and they're just trying to look for someone to sort it out. But nobody can help you recover your social media account that's been hacked. Only the social media platform or yourself. But what happens is that you either pay this user to try and get your account back and they just take your money, or you give this user your access details and they try and hack you again. You then get your usual crypto bots promising that if you send them $100, they'll magically turn it into $1,000, for example. And these are the most common bots that you generally can clock. They're incredibly spammy, but luckily they're quite easy to spot. But then there are bots which are becoming a lot harder to spot because their intent to scam isn't so obvious. This is an example of the bot I spoke about early on in the video, who was offering advice, posting about their personal experience, and even creating their own content. Those bots are the biggest issue and possibly the future of the internet. So now there is this new reason why bots are being created. And this opens up a whole new can of worms. Bots are now being created with the intention of selling the bot account to someone else. And then that someone else will be able to do some sort of malicious activity. Here's how it works. The bot is created and acts very human-like. It then gains trust of the social media platform. And over time, nobody suspects it's a bot because it's not really selling a service, producing scammy links, or saying anything that's harmful or suspicious. Eventually, the creator sells a bot, or even a batch of these bots, to a third party who uses them to artificially boost engagement for specific content or posts. And this is quite common when someone wants to sell a product or a service. Let's say you want to sell really cheap quality t-shirts, but you don't want to spend thousands on advertising through the traditional methods, like Facebook or Instagram ads. Instead, you spend $100 and buy 1,000 Instagram bots. You post about your product on Instagram and your bots get to work. They all like the post and leave comments in a really natural way. Some comments are positive, some are neutral, and some are even slightly negative, just to make it look authentic. Then the Instagram algorithm sees your post gaining a lot of traction, and it assumes it's because human users find it engaging. So it then boosts your post onto everyone's home feed. And now real people see your post, and some even end up clicking and buying your product. And that kind of bot activity is happening a lot. There is also a market for that. Here is someone who posted on a popular forum that is searching for a developer who has a bot that can manage hundreds of accounts, which people did respond to. And this method is scary because the first stage is creating bots that act like humans. And these bots are creating content, they're posting comments, they're even replying to our comments, just like how humans do. They're incredibly hard to spot. And as a result, you may be consuming content every day that's no longer created by humans. And eventually, that content can turn slightly malicious and you may not even know. Currently, it doesn't look like we can even quantify how much content we encounter daily that's generated by bots. And even worse is that this content isn't moderated. It's also extremely hard to track these bots back to the original source or the original human. And unfortunately, recent data shows that human-generated traffic has dipped to just 50.4%, meaning organic interactions are declining and one in two posts that you see may actually be created by a bot. This trend is also likely to continue, and it doesn't look like this problem is going to be solved anytime soon. Thank you so much for watching. If you like my content, please like, comment, and subscribe. I promise you, I'm not a bot, and I'll see you on the next one. Bye.